Hello, it is myself, Paul Neat, and I'm joined by Dayan. We're going to do the super match because it is coming up very soon. And I have something to show you, actually, Dayan, and the viewers at home. It's this, which is actually your shirt that you gave me. So, again, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Dayan actually scored in this shirt against Ulsan towards the end of last season. So, I'm going to see if I can score in this shirt, which, given my very limited skills on FIFA.
Don't worry, it's going to be much easier with that number.
Yeah. Right, okay.
Hi there, everybody. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith is my sidekick today.
Teams come out. When you pulled on the blue shirt, the famous blue Suwon shirt for the first time, how did that feel?
Oh, man, really strange. Honestly, they asked me about this. I said, guys, black and red, and now it's blue. It was really strange, but couldn't be better. Luckily, everyone really helped me a lot.
Yeah.
To this first part of not adaptation, just of this new team, but really familiar team goes really smooth, and they treat me like I'm there a few years, not a few days or a few weeks. So
yeah,
it was strange, but it was okay. First two games, I scored goals. Preseason, we went really well. So everything, this first part went really well, and now it's, I feel really, let's go.
Yeah, go.
I feel okay.
Okay.
X.
So, what, your first day of training, do you feel nervous? Meeting with all these people? Well, also, you met them before, but
I feel it. You cannot say, I feel it, not because, I know them, but.
Yes.
How they gonna approach me, what they gonna say, how fans gonna react, everything was...
So who was the first person that came over to you on your first day?
Well, these older players,
yeah.
I play against them last 10 years, from 2008 some players play against me, and we play final, K-League final 2008, so they came first, they can speak English, then it's Sang Min.
Yeah.
Kiyu, normal. So, really, everything went really well. I was like a little bit concerned, but everything was okay. Ay, de, vamos! So, yeah, everything went really well.
Good, yeah.
It looks like I was concerned without any reason.
Yeah, well, yeah. I mean, first day of a new job, it's natural, isn't it? It's still a bit nervous.
Yeah, man, when I came back to Seoul 2016, I feel nervous. It's normal, you know, first day, even I was there so long. No, first day, everything's going to go.
But then you signed, and then the team went straight on a pre-season training camp. So being away from Suwon, being away together, that must have helped.
Yeah,
you get to know everybody, yeah?
Yeah. And coach staff and everyone really helped.
Yeah.
Some advice, everything is okay, how I feel, what I think. Man, unbelievable. I cannot say anything. Everything perfect.
So who's your new roommate?
Matt.
Oh, my German, right, okay.
He's my roommate, but now he's injured, and I hope so. He's gonna get well soon, and he's gonna be back in my room.
Yeah.
It's boring. he's my roommate, and probably he's gonna be my roommate this year.
I see. Did you get to pick, or did they just say?
They told me I'm gonna be with him, but I didn't even complain about.
Yeah.
I will not complain about anyone, but for sure I will not complain about him.
Sure. So.
Really nice guy. Speaking of.
So you made your debut obviously against Tan Hoa, and you scored.
Yeah.
How much was a relief to score on your debut?
I didn't put pressure on myself about this because I knew I will score goal.
Right.
Sooner or later that's gonna happen because I'm playing a good team who can make chances, and last year they make a lot of chances for strikers, so I was not too much concerned about this, but coach said, you must score goal, and he feel more relaxed than me after this game, be- because I scored.
Yeah, yeah. Because he kept going for the 90 minutes and...
Yeah, he didn't want to change me, I saw that. No, he didn't even ask me, how are you feeling, man? You must play, you must score.
Yeah, it must be nice to have, like, the belief of the coach behind you by that.
This is what I really miss for a long time, and honestly, I'm really enjoying every day with him, and I hope so. We're going to have a really good season.
This guy
deserved this. And I see that all players and everyone in the club support him. He's really nice guy.
Yeah, because he's still a legend, isn't he?
Yeah,
as a player as well.
Like a player, but here a lot of our legends. I'm not looking that. For me, it's more important how he behaved as a person.
Right.
Okay. He's not classical, yeah. He really understand. He was outside, so he really understand the foreigners, and he's really trying to help in every way. So,
Do you think the fact that he's won lots of titles in his career as a player, that helps the players that are playing for him now to believe in his methods, because he's won it all before?
I think just... he deserved this kind of things with his behavior when he was not the best.
Right.
When the team last year and before that performed so, had like empty games, you know, a few games without points, without wins. He was not panic like all the coaches start the suits up. He was the guy who always support, speak nice, trying to ask players about opinion, about what they think about everything. And this is how you not buy, how you make players believe.
To take the lead, that is the first goal.
Yeah,
and it could be the one that actually shapes the destiny of the day.
I've been trying to change the team, but it messed up. But a goal for Choyong-uk.
Kicking the flag.
Yeah, kicking the flag.
Disrespect.
Choyong-uk, the new boy.
This is what is more important. You know, he was not in panic like all Koreans and start doing these crazy things and yelling, and he was really nice. Even now, we have a few games without results what we expect, and everything's okay. This is what players like to see. He believes in us, he's giving us confidence, making the team believe in themselves, how much he believes in us. So,
right.
This is what is very important.
So his man management skills are very good. What's he like with tactics? Is he big on tactics? Because I know some managers like to give the players a little bit of freedom and let their own sort of skills come out by itself. Is he the kind of person that will be heavy on tactics, or?
No, he's trying. He's trying, especially with young players, to show them and explain them things they need to see on the game. I think he's okay. I think it's okay. Now we are not performing well, and it's not about him, it's about us. We cannot do some things what we did in the whole pre-season and last year, I think. So
like, for instance, after the first game of the season where you lost, what do you say afterwards? Was he angry at all?
No. Maybe he was angry, but he's not showing that. He's not saying, because I think he knows that if he shows from first game, it's going to be just opposite reaction from players.
Right. We're going to shoot from here. Ooh, cheeky.
Doyan. So really okay. I'm more than happy with him and with his style of controlling the team.
Yeah.
And, you know, taking care of the team like Suwon. The biggest team. Fact.
True.
Yeah, so I think because of him and how he's doing all of this, I think everything's going to be fine.
Yeah.
I see that he believes in him and his style. So if something like this must happen, it's better to happen now than in the middle of the season.
Yeah.
When it's the most important. So I think this is just bad luck in the beginning. Until he made the interception. Overcome that now on Saturday, you mentioned that Tuesday.
Yeah, well, there's been a lot of new players coming in. It takes time, doesn't it? For because Wagnerino, you're there as well, Im Sang-hyo, all these players. It's not easy to get a new attacking sort of section
Jay Robinson. I cannot say that we need too much time to adapt. You know what I can? You need to explain it, and so what we need to do. And I think all players knows me really well, what I can do. I cannot make too much excuse for that. Everybody need to take responsibility of his position and the team where they are playing. And so on, they must know this is a small team. They cannot just wait ball or just wait one chance in three games. They must make chance every game. This team like Suwon must play to win every game, not to lose. I was saying this last year, same in Seoul. So
there's one question that we got in from Tom Harmon, who said that if in the Super Match it's 90 minutes, it's 0-0, and Suwon get a penalty, are you taking it?
For sure.
Yeah?
For sure. I know it's going to be full stress and how I miss against Kashima, but my job is there. Only if coach chooses, for example, Kiyun and speak, okay, if Kiyun take, okay, but if he doesn't speak anything, I'm going to take it.
Right.
Now here's a chance from winning the ball. In with a
chance.
And celebrate an equaliser here.
Celebration. Kick that flag.
Yeah. Thanks for the assist.
You can't have scored any better than this.
Yeah.
The Bendy's imparted onto the ball.
Fair enough. You were the number 9 in your last stint at FC Seoul. You were the number 10 before that. You got the number 10 shirt back. Was that important to you?
No, but they told me it's free, so I took it.
Okay.
And, you know, I had really good two seasons with number 9, and I'm not too much superstition about these things. But if I can choose, I will choose number 10.
I see.
But you know, if they said there is no number 10, it's going to be number 9, I will not take any problem.
Right. I see.
But you know, if it's available like now, yeah, for sure I'm going to take it.
Are squad numbers important to other players? Do you think? Does it really matter if the player can't get their preferred squad number?
Yeah, there are some players who have some for some numbers, for example, something in his past or more like that, and he play and he had some good season in that number, and he think now it's only about number.
Right, I see.
I understand that even me, if you now offer me number, I don't know, 7, 8, any number except 9 or 10, no.
Right,
you must find me one of these numbers. I don't care. But I will not say, you must number 10 or I will not do it. But there are some players, you know, they have superstition, they have some jinx, and they think the number is very important, so I understand that.
Yeah.
Everyone has some opinion and his style of choosing numbers of his life or his behavior, so I don't care. For me, it's okay. Give me 9 or 10. Okay.
Fair enough. So, It's been a while since we've spoke about the transfer. Did you expect the reaction that people had? Because the FC Seoul website almost died. There was such a huge reaction to
the
transfer.
Honestly, you know, we spoke about this, and they choose them.
Right.
They knew that. What they think, like I am gonna move to, for example, I will sign for Suwon, and it's gonna be what? We're gonna hide it, or that just they're gonna what, close the site, or I don't understand. I'm somebody who make the best part of FC Seoul history.
Yeah.
I'm the best foreigner ever. You know, this is history. You cannot forget that. I know they are my fans now. There are some of them angry, and they're running my jerseys, flags. And I understand that, but still you cannot forget what I did.
No.
So club choose this. My friend, sorry.
No. Oh, Yang Hanbin, he's top class.
Damn, sorry guys. For bad words.
I'll beat that out.
They knew that they choose that. Maybe they believe that I will not sign in Korea.
Right.
Maybe they thought maybe I will just move from outside from Korea. Everything's gonna go smooth for them.
Yeah.
They forget what I said. I said I wanna finish football here. My plan is to finish football in Korea. I'm sorry for that, but these guys choose that.
There's a chance really of getting
fans, I think they understand.
Yes, I think the fans at first were angry with the
without doubt, angry. But, more on Klopp than
yes, me. Yeah. So because it wasn't just you that left it well. I mean, all in the off season, Solomon had let Osmar go.
Yeah,
let Unilock go as well. These are three important players that.
Last year, players who made everything.
Mm.
But that's them. I don't want to speak too much. This is
true.
Their decision. They put some story. They're gonna do some rebuilding. They okay, man. That's what they can do, and I don't care anymore. They are making decisions. They are taking responsibility for that. They cannot hide behind that. Now they did that, and they need to, you know, take responsibility for everything what's happened this year, good or bad. So they decided, they choose, they stand behind their decision, so that's okay, man.
Fair enough.
Just, I don't want, like, that guy, Steve. I don't know who is that guy.
Oh, yeah. Well,
he made these fake stories on Twitter, and I text him, don't do that, you know.
Yeah, I saw that.
I don't know if you are for FC Seoul, or you have some I don't know, friends there, and you think this is good what they're doing, that's all fake. He might only that when I say what he does. It's there now. I'm a player of Suwon, and I have now things to fix in Suwon and try to do the best I can there. And Seoul is really nice history, but
I finished with Seoul. So you signed a two-year contract, obviously. And,
one plus one.
I see. Right. When the fixtures came out, was the Superbacks the first one that you looked for?
They told me, yeah, fourth game, they are coming out of place, and for Children's Day, May 5th, we're going to play Seoul. I said, man, I wait this game because of, I know stadium will be full,
mm-hmm,
and atmosphere will be perfect. Finally, football atmosphere.
Yes.
What every player wants to see. So I'm really happy to play on Seoul Stadium on this Children's Day, because always stadium, you know, is full and the atmosphere is really good. So first, but until May 5, we have so many games, I cannot even think about Super Match.
True. It's because the first Supermatch this season that is coming up quite soon is at Suwon. Do you think that worked out best for you? Do you think it would be best to have the first one after your transfer, being in your new stadium with your fans there?
Honestly, I think that's not important, because I think this home advantage in this game is not important, not
right,
too much. Every time when we were much better than Suwon, they won against us. When they were better and they play better, we won, so doesn't mean anything. This
right
is really, really different game, and the biggest match in Korea, and with fans and with this pressure, you know, stadium is maybe for some player important, but for some main result, and this last result, it's not important. So I didn't look where I'm gonna play super match. I just wanna be healthy, in good shape, in good form, and just play one good game. And that's all I need to do. This is my job, and I want this super match to go to make like really good game, not a big issue about me and Seoul and these things what they are trying to make now less, honestly. But in the beginning, they were like, man, what you gonna be, man? What is gonna be, man? I came to play football, I didn't want to fight anyone.
Yeah.
I did there, scored a goal in 89 minutes. Ah, Hanbin.
Hanbin is good, isn't he? He's good,
man. He's national team potential, and I hope so. They're gonna call him. So I really like this guy.
Yeah, he's a good keeper. There's quite lucky at the moment. Korea got some good goalkeepers. It's a shame that Yan Hanbin has been overlooked, I think, that he's not been in the squad for the national team.
Yeah,
he's definitely got the potential, hasn't he?
Yeah, but you know, one more good season like last year, he saved so many times. I think he deserved to have some for friendly game call and give him some chance, and then we're gonna save him.
So we've not got much time left, because it's 90 odd minutes. But one question I want to ask you is: when you first heard Suwon fans chanting your name after being a Seoul player for so long, how did that feel?
Really nice.
Yeah.
You know, that means I know I was the biggest opponent. I know they speak so many bad words to me when I was playing, but they respect me that time. And now when I came there for the first time I signed for Suwon, I receive only nice and good messages, you know, welcome messages, you know, support. Nobody speak bad, like why you came here and these kind of things. unbelievable. Now they are every game sending the messages even now. This hard start, so I mean, it's really nice feeling. The biggest opponent is like cheering your name, really supporting you, like you are there for a long time. So that means I was doing really good thing, not only on the pitch.
Yeah. All right, well, thank you very much.
Thank you, man. You saved yourself this game.
Finish 1-1. Maybe
Hambin MVP.
Yeah. Well, thank you for watching. The Supermatch is coming up very soon. So if it finishes 1-1, that might ease the tension a little bit.
I hope so. It's not going to be finished like this.
Yeah. Maybe you will get a 90th minute penalty.
Yeah. No, let's make goal without penalty. Then if some penalty happens, it's going to be full issue about penalties.